Hey crypto friends, how's it going? I'm Michael Selbel. Today I would like to install a wallet for RADIX. I also want to transfer my RADIX from Bitfinex into my wallet. On bitfinex.com, I dollar cost averaged into RADIX over the last couple of months. I started when it was around 10 cents and then it went up in price and I stopped DCAing into RADIX. And now that it cooled down, I started again. Now I've got a total of around 7,000 RADIX and that is about $2,000. So it's time to remove it from the exchange into a wallet so that I can do something with that. I am on wallet.radixdlt.com and here I can download the RADIX wallet. I will download this wallet for Windows because I'm on a Windows computer and then install it. I will not film the installation, but I will go ahead with that. After this installation, I've got two options. If I already have a RADIX wallet account, I can click on Restore a Previous Wallet. This would ask me for the 12-word phrase which protects a RADIX wallet. And then I would define a password and a PIN, and then I would be able to use an existing wallet account in this new installation. But I don't have a wallet account yet, so I will click Create a New Wallet. This will show me a new 12-word phrase, which I will not show in this video, obviously. But let's do that. And now I have to write down this seed phrase, store it in a super safe place, and then continue with the password. I will not film how I write it down or store it. I will just skip to the password. I'm done with the seed phrase. And now I am choosing a password for this installation of the wallet. I confirm. Now I have to choose a PIN. Let's do this. And click Confirm PIN. Let's name this account Base Account because the word RADIX reminds me of the word base. So this is the base account. I click save. Now I've got a RADIX wallet. The wallet address is this one over here. I can copy this address and send some RADIX over here. Let's go back to Bitfinex. There I go to wallet and then withdraw. Under cryptocurrencies, I select RADIX. I click on the available XRD balance over here. This pre-fills the amount. And here I have to paste in the wallet address from the RADIX wallet. There we go. Now I have to confirm that I agree to the conditions and I can request the withdrawal. I have to provide the two-factor authentication token from my Google Authenticator. And I have to copy this confirmation number into the field. And confirm. And in the last step, I have to confirm in an email. I'm not going to show my email inbox right now, but I go there and confirm. Okay. I confirmed this withdrawal. The status of the withdrawal is user approved. And now it will take a bit of time until it will arrive in my wallet. I just have to wait. The status updated to completed. Let's have a look in the wallet. And yes, my RADIX is over here. Now I can do something with it. I can stake it, for example, but that's something for another video. All right, I hope this is helpful for you? Let me know in the comments what you think, and I hope I see you in the next video.